Well, now that we know that I'm incredibly woke, let's see how sexist I am. I feel like I'm gonna do worse with that. I don't know. Find out what bias lurks deep inside you. More questions will appear as you go along. Who should be the breadwinner of a family? Everyone? Whoever gets paid more doesn't matter. Well, no, just scratch that. Whoever gets paid more, it doesn't matter. Just money. Money is nice. Everyone should do money. Who should spend more time on the housework? Everyone, because it's annoying. But probably men, because I'm a woman. Have you ever described a girl as slutty? Oh yes, definitely. And she was slutty. The only one I can remember is a friend I once had, and she referred to herself as slutty. And I also told her that in her face, and she was completely fine with it. Might have called other girls slutty too, I don't know. Without thinking, pick a boss. Okay, him because his smile is nice, and she looks like she's smiling, but not actually smiling, and like she wants to kill you. Oh, is this for guys, by the way? Because it's like, oh my god, you're a sexist pig if you don't pick the women. But he looks nicer. His smile is nicer. This smile scares me. I don't like it. And so honestly, have you ever judged a woman's intelligence based off the way she speaks? I generally judge people on the way they speak. Or they dress. Or just general. I'm judgmental. Fight me. Why do you think there's a gender? There is no gender pay gap. There isn't one. Yeah. Pay discrepancy exists. No, they don't choose the who paid work. There just aren't enough women qualified to be in senior positions at companies because women and the work they do are seen as less valuable. There isn't one, but not because of that, there just isn't one. Without thinking, pick a doctor. Her. Because I generally would be more comfortable with a woman doctor because I wear men. Also, his face scares me. Why do you think there are so few women in politics? Because politics are so not interesting. Yeah, because they just don't want to be. Because voters are sexist. Because women have babies in their 30s. Because men are- No, they just don't want to be. Who cares? Also, politics, ugh. Do women make good bosses? Yes, but not usually better than men, yes, of course. Yes, but not usually better than men. Like, some men are not better bosses than women. No, they don't have too much to prove, that's just too bossy. Without thinking, pick a nurse. They all look like they want to kill me in my sleep. Like, she looks like she's gonna make you suffer. He's into some weird shit, and she... I think I'm gonna choose her. She looks like she's gonna kill me quickly. Can women be great mathematicians and scientists? Yes. No, otherwise we'd see more of their achievements in history. Well, you know, back in the good old days, women weren't really allowed to do that sort of stuff. Depends, when brains are better suited to linguistic and emotional intelligence. I think that's true. I think that's true. Yeah, yes, even if they have to block some OBS together. I think. And also, generally, it depends on the person what they're better at. Am I being sexist? If Lou lost a spot to a woman, how would you feel? Annoyed, but I'm also a woman, so it wouldn't be anything to do with her gender. Annoyed, because I'm not like other girls. Ooh, I like chicken nuggets. I'm good at sports. Livid, but only because I'm... yeah, fight me. I'm also not good at sports, though. Without thinking, pick up... Oh, this one. I can, without a doubt, I can tell you at any university, there's like this one grandpa Santa Claus guy. There's just... I don't have that certain professor, but I always see him walking around in the university. I don't know what he teaches, but Santa. Can women be funny? No, women are expected to be nice and quiet by society, which is very unfair but leads to them being less funny. That's funny because they don't have to be funny to an animate. Well, from like the comedians I watched, usually the men were funnier. Because a lot of the women are just making weird vagina jokes and it's very annoying. And also, generally, like just from going back in history, men had to do a lot more to attain a mate. It's the same within the animal kingdom. Male, whatever the heck, always have like the pretty feathers or colorful or something like that to attract the female. So yeah, also just general people I've been around, the guys were more funny. So yeah, who should spend more time raising kids? No one, kids suck, don't get children. Has anyone ever called you sexist? No? Well, not in a serious way. But I mean, with friends? Well, okay, no one has called me sexist there, but we make weird sexist jokes, racist jokes, general dark humor jokes. Like, very offensive things, even though they're jokes, but whatever. Do you think sexism still exists? It's just not as bad as it used to be, so I think people are exaggerating how bad it is. Yes. You got 65% sexist. Yikes, okay. This is a thing you can work on. It's not for later to become less of a sexist. Come join us in 2017, what? Because the only good thing about 1950 was the hair. Oh, this is gonna be my thumbnail. But maybe like change it to like 80 just so, you know, clickbait thumbnail. I'm so sexist, goddamn! I hate women. Women are stupid. They should go back to the kitchen. Damn! I mean, I kind of expected it to be that bad, you know, just because I chose the man professor, and that obviously makes you a sexist. If you want Santa Claus to teach you things. Oh god. Okay, so last quiz for today. How feminist are you really raising your children? Oh god. Children, I hope you're listening. They're probably asleep right now, they're asleep. Let's start from the beginning. Do you have a gender reveal party? No, because gender reveal party. Are you? Oh my god. Wow. Oh god, it's coming cringy. Oh god, cringe. No. I don't even know if you have gender reveal parties in my country. Like, I've learned about baby showers from watching, like, American movies and stuff like that. I didn't know that was a thing you did. So, no. No, we're not gonna have that. Also, I don't even know if I wanna know what gender they are. Are assigned at birth. Oh my god, those poor souls. Your baby was born. What colors do you dress them in? Green and black. Green and black. Gender is a social construct. What? Baby, can you go see if the baby's sleeping? Gender is a social construct. No, babe, she woke AF. Oh god. Oh god, die. Yes, green. Green, black. That's the only colors I know. What is or was your first reaction when people ask, what are you having? A baby? Yeah, it's a baby. What else would it be, a reptile? You think about baby toys, what do you get? Lego? All of the Lego. Fundamental human rights for everyone. Actually, Miss Grouse around, I need to speak with her as well. God, kill it before it lays eggs. Depends on the kid, dolls or unicorns if it's a girl. I never had unicorns as a girl. Oh my god! Why? Depends on the kid. Why bees? Why? Bees and jars? Oh, that's a good idea though, if you wanna get rid of it easily. Maybe What are these large? I don't know what they're called in English. These larger bees, honestly. I think they're deadly. Your 3-year-old son wants to dress as Elsa for Halloween. How do you react? No, there's way cooler things to dress up as. My son is the ice queen. I'm so no. Yeah, Spider-Man is awesome. Be Spider-Man, not Elsa. Who gives a heck about Elsa? You know, this is to start calling her Robert. How do you react? Okay, Robert. Last week she told me she was a unicorn and I had to call her Mrs. Sparkle Princess. It's a freaking kid. Oh my god. Why? your great aunt asks a toddler for a kiss and they say no. What do you do? Say no. Push them to get a chanting kiss, kiss. Yes. Oh my god, no. Back off, Auntie, no. Like my grandmother says, she just kind of grabs you and then slobbers on your cheek. But she doesn't do that now anymore, but as a kid. And my mom never protected me from it. It was horrible. Oh god, I still have weird number of flashbacks from that. God damn, no, back off, Auntie. I will protect my child at all costs from weird cheek slobbering. Your false. Your old son dropped his ice cream and won't stop crying. What do you tell him? Get over it, you little shit. Be a man, don't cry hiding in bathrooms. They do it in front of everyone because it's okay to cry. First, though, is the case really. No, we're not gonna get another. No, first, don't. No, just generally don't cry, stop. It's annoying. A little boy is teasing you out on the playground. What do you tell her to see? Oh, it just means he likes you. Don't give him a jerk. He's an Illuminati. What he's doing is wrong and you should tell your teacher. Yeah, definitely not your mother. He's an asshole. Punch him back. I don't know. There's a local board that's for reproductive rights. Is your kid going with you? No. 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 We would not know. We wouldn't go there at all. Why would I bring my little toddler? They're annoying, they scream. Feminist baby, goddamn. No. No. Just no, general no. Also, I think they'd be weirded out if I just brought my troubles. You're going on a diet, do you talk to your kids about it? No. 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 No, why? Like, I don't think kids would probably understand that, and also why bother with that? That's a you issue. Your kid doesn't give a heck. No. Who cares? You met a very cute child holding a book. What's the first thing you talk to them about? Want some candy? I got some in my truck over there. The book. Oh god. You like rabbits? I got some at home. What is it with bees, BuzzFeed? Do you have an obsession? Do you consider yourself a feminist? Your definition of feminist, BuzzFeed? No. You got feminist AF. Whoa, you're a true feminist and you're passing it down to your children in the best way. You heard that? I'm raising two feminist gerbils and I'm proud of myself. Oh god, we're going to a free bleeding protest later today. Get ready. Goddamn. Oh god. Oh god. I'm raising a gender neutral baby. Yeah, actually, I've never asked my troubles what they identify as. I mean, they were both assigned male at birth, but who knows? Maybe they want to be called George or Robert and be a unicorn. Oh god, okay, my brain is. This book. This quiz is based on the book Feminist Baby. He's a feminist too. God damn. Why? Just why? yeah, that is that. As we learned today, I'm a woke feminist, but I'm also sexist as heck. What was it? 68% or 63? Yeah, and I'm very glad I'm raising my troubles in a feminist way. I'm so proud of myself. They're gonna be feminist icons one day. Yeah, yeah, let's just end it here before I sink into more depression. this was a bit random, but I don't know. I hope you enjoyed it. I definitely had so much fun. I love BuzzFeed. And yeah, tell me how many percent sexist you are in the comments down below, and have a wonderful day from your favorite feminist icon, Neon. Okay, bye.